311. Please stand.
Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and sit at my table where saints and sinners are friends. I wait.
Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to our 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Let's begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Today we're praying especially for all the families affected by the war in the Middle East. As we prepare to celebrate, let's call to mind our faults, our sins, our troubles and concerns, and ask our loving God for mercy and forgiveness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
You take away the sin.
Let us pray. May your grace, O Lord, we pray, at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines, juicy, rich food and pure choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from every face. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord has spoken. On that day it will be said, "Behold our God, to whom we looked to save us. This is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has saved us." For the hand of the Lord will rest on this mountain. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The responsorial psalm can be found on page 207.
Of
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, I know how to live in humble circumstances. I know also how to live with abundance. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance and of being in need. I can do all things in Him who strengthens me. Still, it was kind of you to share in my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accord with our glorious riches in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father, glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus again, in reply, spoke to the chief priests and elders of the people in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon and invite the guests to the feast, but they refused to come. A second time he sent other servants, saying, 'Tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and fatted cattle are killed, and everything was ready. Come to the feast.' Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers, and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy to come. Go out, therefore, into the main roads and invite to the feast whomever you find.' The servants went out into the streets and gathered all they found, bad and good alike, and the hall was filled with guests." The Gospel of the Lord. I've been very appalled all week over the senseless violence and war in the Middle East. To wake up one morning and find that children were being murdered in front of their parents, and parents murdered in front of their children, whole families wiped out in senseless acts of hate. Any other homily I had written at the end of early this week, I just threw in the trash. And today I beg your prayers for all that senseless violence and murder in the Middle East. We're so blessed to live here in Wisconsin. Yes, we have our own troubles, but nothing like that. Every day the news gets worse. I've been thinking about just violence and hate all week long. And those feelings of hatred have burned for generations. Will there ever be peace? I kind of doubt it. The hate burns too deep. But we can always pray, and we can always hope for some peaceful situation, some resolution to that senseless war. I'm sure we've all been watching the news. It's heartbreaking. I can't picture children being senselessly murdered and families being wiped out just out of the blue. As it may be angry, oh, you bet. But all the anger I feel, I'm praying for hope and peace. So today I beg your prayers for all the innocents who have lost their lives. We could supercharge our prayer today by the Eucharist that we consecrate together. And when we take communion in ourselves, we can supercharge our prayers. And I'm sure that every Catholic church in the country is praying for the same thing. Our ways have not been God's ways the last week. I hope that God, as Isaiah said, could gently wipe the tears from the eyes of those who suffer. But for our liturgies this week, let's do what we do best and pray. Let's together pray the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. God invites us to pray for peace. Pray that we respond to the call to pray for lost innocence.
For the whole earth, that God will remove our divisions and bring us peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who protect our freedoms, that God will protect them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer and mourn and weep, that God will bring them comfort. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our church, that we acknowledge the bounty God provides and freely share it with others, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In gratitude and thanksgiving for the 120th anniversary of St. Casimir Church, may our prayers be living stones gathered and sown in our community. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On the anniversary of the bonfire tragedy, pour out, we pray, O God, your love, grace, and peace into the hearts of all who were affected. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may live in the house of the Lord and rejoice in the banquet of eternal life. Especially Nancy Foster Baran, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray especially for all the innocent lives lost this week. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving God, we thank you for your grace. Help us to be worthy of your abundant blessings freely given. All glory and honor to you, Almighty God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Our song during the preparation of gifts is number 533, Let There Be Peace on Earth, 533.
Please join us.
Let there be peace on earth, and let it begin with me. Let there be peace on earth, the peace that was meant to be. Peace on earth, and let it begin with.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. Wash me, O Lord, from my iniquity and cleanse me of my sin. Thank you. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
We accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his church.
Accept, O Lord, the prayers of your faithful, with the sacrificial offerings that through these acts of devotedness we may pass over to the glory of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just to give you glory, Father most holy, for you are the one God, living and true, existing before all ages and abiding for all eternity, dwelling in unapproachable light. Yet you, who alone are good, the source of life, have made all that is, so that you might fill in your creatures with blessings and bring forth to many of them the glory of your light. And so in your presence are countless hosts of angels who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your face, glorify you without ceasing. With them, we too confess your name in exaltation, giving voice to carry every creature under heaven as we acclaim. We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great, and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed us in your own image and trusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone as the Creator, we might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience we had lost your friendship, you did not abandon us to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior, made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. He shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, He sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits of those who believe. And so, bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, make the same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these gifts, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. For in the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant, for whom when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took the bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave his chalice to his disciples, saying, take this all of you and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and his ascension to your right hand. And as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered together into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may become a living sacrifice in Christ to praise of your glory. Therefore, Father, remember now for all whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, David, our Bishop, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your apostles and saints in your kingdom, there with the whole creation freed from the corruption of sin and death, we may glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let's offer one another the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our song during communion is number 415, In Christ Alone, 415.
In Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm.
Came to save, till on that cross.
What has passed our lips as food, O Lord, may we accept in purity of heart, that what has been given to us in time may be our healing for eternity. Let us pray. Loving God, helps to embrace the beauty and grace of this sacrament, and through his goodness, increase our prayers for all the innocents that have been lost in the world today. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you. The Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Are you speaking for? Go right ahead. We have a Vincent DePaul talk. Please be seated.
The Badgers are losing, by the way.
Hello, my name is Jim Resick. I currently serve as president of St. Vincent de Paul Society for its ABVM conference. I want to share with you an opportunity to put your faith into action in a practical way while growing spiritually. We are an international lay organization with thousands of conferences worldwide, the ABVM conference being one of 22 in the Green Bay District. Our co-founder, Blessed Frederick Ozenham, said at our founding in 1834, "Let us go to the poor." We carry on that mission today in many forms to serve diverse people. I want to thank all of those in the parish who have volunteered and shopped at our stores or who have donated goods. Revenue from our Green Bay stores supports not only direct charity to friends in need, but also systemic change programs like Getting Ahead, which prepares folks coming from intergenerational poverty to live productive lives. Our primary activity is the home visit, where our volunteers go in twos to meet face-to-face with a household and understand more clearly what type of help is needed. We go with openness to the gospel directive to see Jesus in those we serve. In our most recent fiscal year, we met with and helped 19 households locally. This typically took the form of rent or utility assistance, clothing and furniture vouchers, or help with transportation to work and medical appointments. One doesn't have to commit to doing home visits in order to participate in St. Vincent de Paul here. There are many other volunteer roles that serve the poor and the St. Vincent de Paul organization. We meet in the basement of the church, where we have a spiritual reflection before we get down to business. Our essential elements, our hallmarks, include service, spiritual formation, and friendship among ourselves and then beyond our small circle. If this sounds appealing to you, please stop by one of our volunteers at the exits today and share your contact information. You will receive a reminder email or phone call about this Wednesday's information meeting at 6:30 p.m. in the St. Clair Room, and that is also our monthly social gathering. Please prayerfully consider coming to hear about this opportunity to serve and grow in your faith walk. Thanks, Father, for allowing me to speak today.
My sisters and brothers, pray with everything you have for an end to senseless war and conflict and violence. And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let's go in peace, glorifying Christ by our lives.
Our sending forth song is number 449, Amazing Grace, 449.
Amen.